Now let's look at the image acquisition pipeline. This is something, again, we've discussed differently when we talked about cameras, but now let's talk about it in detail in this context. Of course, we start off with a 3D scene. And of course, this scene is being captured, and basically the capturing information is called the scene radians, referred to as L. And basically what the units here describe is watts per steradian meters squared. Steradian is a measure of the solid angle. And because these are 3D scenes and the light is coming out in form of a cone from everywhere, the basic idea we want to do is use the cone information to capture the light. So in essence, what that basically means is if I have a scene, what I will be doing basically is using a cone, and the steradian is basically kind of counting for all of the information that's in this cone from any point. And that's basically allows us to kind of have an area from that point onwards. So just to reiterate, scene radians, referred to as L, is basically watts, which is energy, per steradian meter squared. Steradian is the measure of the solid angle, primarily because, again, this is a 3D scene and the light is coming out in form of a cone from everywhere. Of course, when we have a 3D scene, to capture an image from it, what do we need? Of course, optics. So here, basically, now we use the lens and optics, and that converts all of this 3D light information. That's why we have the solid angle and the cone basically coming in. And now, of course, we have a 2D sensor. So we, of course, do not have the information from steradians, but we do have watts per meter square. And we know that was something we referred to as sensor irradiance, and it's something we've been labeling as E. This is a linear mapping. Once I know this, and if I have this information, when it hits the screen, I can actually now, or a sensor, I know what this measure would be. Next stage in the pipeline, of course, is the shutter, because shutter is the amount of time a light is allowed into my sensor. And we know that basically E times delta T gives us the information towards getting the sensor exposure. And you may recall, of course, that we referred to the exposure as H, which was equal to the sensor irradiance and amount of time the shutter was open. And this is something, again, we've looked at before. So in essence, we'll be going from 3D scene, and now we're getting sensor information and the exposure values. Continuing on, we basically now will have a sensor, which would be a CCD. Again, we covered the details of how a CCD works. Light comes into a CCD, and what we basically get is electrons collecting, and depletion layer kind of collects it. In essence, what we're doing is computing the voltages at different types of capacitors within a CCD. Next step, of course, is an analog to digital converter. Basically takes these voltages and converts them into digital values to give you a raw image. And of course, then we want to do some sort of remapping from the raw image. Again, if you were doing camera raw, you would just use this information. But sometimes you basically get compressed pixel information of intensities, and that's where we get the intensities out of it. We have covered each and every aspect of this earlier, and you can refer back to the previous lectures on this one. But the bottom line is, from 3D scene, once we have the scene irradiance, there's a linear mapping to get sensor irradiance. There's another linear mapping based on, again, the time opening to get the exposures. And then there is a bunch of different operations that happen at the sensor level. So here is one thing we want to note here is this whole process of the pipeline is linear. There are lots of linear mappings going on. This part could all be nonlinear, right? I mean, there are no direct linear equations that would actually let us predict this analysis here. And it also sometimes depends on the kinds of sensors and stuff. But this is linear, and now we need to kind of understand how we can use this to understand, again, information from what's in the scene to what we want on the sensor in terms of an exposure. So far, we've studied the image acquisition pipeline. Now let's look at some of the mathematics associated with it. So of course, this whole pipeline starts off with L, which is the scene radiance, a linear mapping to E, linear mapping to exposure, and then of course, all the way down here to give me intensity values. Of course, we're interested in this pipeline, but we're also interested in the inverse of this pipeline, which lets me compute the inverse. Now, where basically what I'm interested in is I have an image. Can I actually now predict the model of the whole scene intensities here in terms of scene radiance? So I'm interested in both of those, and that's the kind of stuff now let's think about to be able to model.